guys, welcome to Petfish Channel. And today, we're going to show you the 10 steps in breeding bettas, and we will show and guide you through each step right after this. On the first day of breeding, let's select a pair to breed. Today, we're breeding this Copper Rosedale Half Moon pair. You may also choose to cross between several different color patterns of bettas and produce multicolored offsprings. Let's get back to our breeding. Normally, a non-transparent tank should be used to minimize distractions. But in this case, I will use a clear tank so I can film the entire breeding process. And fill it with H water. Let's get to our list of steps. Step 1. Day 1. Male in the tank. Introduce the male betta to the breeding tank. He will explore the tank and after 30 minutes or more, he will claim the tank as his territory. Why not put the pair together directly or add the female first?
Attack formation!
Warning. Warning.
This is important so when we add the female, he will not get scared. He will have the balls to chase the female on the spot. Step 2. Day 1. Water conditioner. Condition the water with crispy dried leaves of Indian almond tree. This will kill bacteria and will protect the eggs from fungus. What if I don't have these leaves? This is optional, but doing so will increase the hatch rate of our fries. Okay, well, I'll order some leaves from Amazon then. Step 3. Day 1. Claim territory. It's been 30 minutes now since we placed him in the tank. He has explored the whole tank, confidently swimming like he's the king. Oh, your highness. When you see that, time for step 4. Step 4. Day 1. Pair introduction. Introduce the pair to each other by placing their tank side by side. This is so they can see each other. So they both can prepare for mating without prematurely fighting. This takes from a day to a week until you feel they're comfortable with each other. How will I know that they're comfortable with each other? You'll know when it's time to do the actual breeding when the male's bubble nest is big. For the female, she will display vertical lines on her body. Let's leave them and come back tomorrow. Step 5. Day 2. Completed bubble nest. Today is day 2, as we can see the bubble nest is big enough to hold hundreds of eggs. This is an indication that they're ready, which brings us to our next step. Step 6, day 2. Intimate. Let's get intimate and add the female in the tank. Step 7. Day 2. Courtship. The male will show off by dancing and flaring his fins. The male will then go and start to persuade the female to mate. Sometimes the female will oppose and will show aggression. But the male is persistent. But my female killed the male when I was breeding. This could be that they're a mismatch. The female is too big and too aggressive for the male. Or either of them hasn't eaten high-protein foods or either one of them is too young for mating. She will soon get dominated by the male, and that brings us to our next step. Step 8, Day 2. Submission. The female will give up and will show submission. Some will swim head down like this one. Other females will just swim directly to the nest and inspect the nest if they're impressed. Otherwise, the female will run away or sometimes destroy the nest. When they're both ready, The female will approach the nest and dance with the male, then our next step happens. Step 9, Day 2. The embrace. This is the egg's pod or ovipositor, which is only found in female bettas. So this is the segregate male from female on placket varieties. Yes, it is. They will start to dance and try several embraces until the male is able to flip the female upside down and squeeze her. When successful, eggs will fall down. The male will catch the eggs and put them in the bubble nest. They will do several embraces until they have fertilized hundreds of eggs. A mature female betta can produce 300 eggs on average or more. Whoa, that's a lot of fries! Look at this female's head pointing down. This is a sign of submission. The eggs keep falling after each embrace, and the male will search for the eggs and deliver to the nest. Look at this, the eggs are seen clearly falling. Again, the male fetches the eggs while the female is left motionless for a few seconds. Is she dead? Don't freak out. This is absolutely normal. The male is very busy during this breeding process. Busier than all of us, that's for sure. He will alternately breed, catch the eggs, and build the nest. What's next? That brings us to our next step. Step 10, Day 2. Scared. Most beginners don't know when to remove the female. Here's a clue, few hours after their embrace. If the female betta is at the opposite part of the tank, away from the nest and acting scared, this simply means that the male is chasing her away from the nest. Oh, he is beating the female after embracing? What's happening? He is overprotecting the eggs from her since most female bettas eat their own eggs. Oh, that explains it. This is also an indication that the breeding process is over. And our go signal to remove her from the breeding tank. Nah, I want her to lay more eggs, just leave them there. You can't do that, dude. You must take out the female betta. Otherwise, the male betta will keep attacking her and might result to severe damage or even death. Aww, I don't want her to die, so just better remove her now. The male will be very busy attending to the eggs and continue building the nest. After 5 to 6 days when all of the fries are free swimmers, then it's time to remove the male. But why would I remove the male? He will love to be with his lovely little fries. Now, if you don't remove him by then, he might start to eat his own fries since he did not eat for a week, and he is starving and exhausted. Oh, I get it. Let's give him high-protein foods to recover from exhaustion and starvation. There you have it, guys. Check out these other videos and be sure to subscribe and click the bell to be notified when we upload new videos.